This is about the supernova everyone on YouTube cannot stop talking about. But there is more to it that you should know. What this actually is. There are a few kind of supernovas that may have been observed, but mainly supernovae may be divided into two broad classes, type 1 and type 2, according to the way in which they detonate. Type 2 supernova happens when a very massive star or a population 1 star of at least 8 solar masses is at the end of its active lifetime. But the more interesting one is type 1 supernova. Type 1 supernova can be divided into 3 subgroups, 1A, 1B and 1C, on the basis of their spectra. The exact nature of the explosion mechanism in type 1 is still uncertain. Although 1A supernovae at least are thought to originate in binary systems consisting of a moderately massive star and a white dwarf with material flowing to the white dwarf from its larger companion. The explosion happens when the white dwarf has eaten enough of its companion star, so the mass of the white dwarf reaches above the Chandrasekhar limit of 1.44 solar masses. But unlike an ordinary supernova, the white dwarf is thought to be completely destroyed in this case. And this creates an extraordinary light show for the people watching it. Something very similar is going on with KIC 9A3-2227, but not exactly similar. In January 2002, a binary star suddenly became the brightest star in the entire Milky Way galaxy. Then just as suddenly, it faded. A stellar flash like this had never been seen before. It was V838 Mon. Stellar collisions are an amazingly rare thing. According to our best estimates, such events occur only in our galaxy within our globular cluster once in every 10,000 years. But everyone thought that was about to change. Professor Lawrence Molnar and his team was keeping an eye on KIC 98337 from 2013, and they found that the star system was about to merge and become the brightest object in the night sky. KIC 983-2227 is a contact binary star system, which means the stars are nearly touching each other. It is located in the constellation Cygnus about 2000 light years away. The stars evolve around each other in just 11 hours. In 2017, Professor Lawrence Molnar came to an unexpected conclusion. The stars will merge in 2022. If that was to happen, then it will be the first of its kind prediction of a red nova event visible to the naked eye. That also means the explosion would have happened about 2000 years ago. But Quentin J. Saucia and William F. Wells and some other astronomers became so excited about this that they wanted to strengthen the very exciting red nova prediction. They used the ESO's Very Large Telescope to again observe the star system, and what they found made them very disappointed. They found that NSVS eclipse time differs by nearly an hour. They were forced to reject the hypothesis by Dr. Molnar. So, sadly, I have to say that KIC 983-2227 is not going to become a supernova, at least in 2022, but very soon. That is not the end. Many astronomical events are waiting for you to see in 2022. And remember, space is the future.